week, a new holiday combining Spain and Portugal. A fortnight in the sun in Yugoslavia. And a return to childhood for one Wish You Were Here reporter.
Hello.
Centre at Yarmouth to find out how they're fighting back. Annika Rice took the ferry from Portsmouth to Ryde, one of half a dozen ways across to the island.
But first to the most famous view on the Isle of Wight, the Needles. On the road west, you see just how rural it is. Downland and fields sweep down to the sea. Pretty villages like Winkle Street and Brystone are featured on coach tours, though plenty of visitors use local buses or bikes. Osborne House, Queen Victoria's favourite country retreat. The grandest rooms are open to the public. The Queen took her private dip from this horse-drawn bathing machine. A modern holiday centre like this one near Yarmouth offers less in the way of living space than Queen Victoria enjoyed, but there's much more to do. Keen holidaymakers start the day with a jog. Indoors and outdoors, there's a score of activities. Squash, netball, tennis, with coaching two mornings a week. And when you've got your breath back, there's always the assault course. The windsurf centre is 5 minutes away in a shuttle bus. Accommodation is in chalets, and half the holidaymakers here choose self-catering chalets, even if dishing up family breakfast may be the closest they get to actual cooking. This is a chalet for people who've opted for full-board or half-board holidays. All the units have private bathrooms. If you want a hairdo or a facial, you can go to the beauty shop or have the beautician come to you. Meals, one sitting, fixed times, are served by waitresses. There's a wine bar and a salad bar. Those are today's sophisticated touches. And in case the English summer gets too hot for you, the dining room is air-conditioned. And as for working off the calories,
this is the gym in the heart of a complex which offers a huge range of sporting action. The only thing is, there's a camera up there monitoring everything we do, which means that someone somewhere is probably watching us. So, no shirking, lads.
Children who shirk the water learn to overcome their fears in the indoor pool where they can have swimming lessons every day. Most of them qualify for a badge and a certificate at the end of the week. The spa pool is heated to 100 degrees, almost like bath time, and the outdoor pools are at 80 degrees, more than warm enough to give you the Mediterranean feeling, but then the Isle of Wight is always near the top of the Sunshine League. The holiday centre sets a very high standard in looking after the disabled. Here, a handicapped guest is being lowered into the pool on a special hoist. All doors are wide enough to take wheelchairs, and there are special weeks for handicapped holidaymakers.
Five and nine is the Brighton line.
Early evening is bingo time for adults and party time for children. They have their own Skylarkers Club. Then, before bedtime, they can join their parents for games and dancing. But now it is bedtime. Parents can leave their children in bed in the chalet. If they wake up or need attention, they'll be alerted through the baby safe system.
Could I have the babysitting service, please?
Yes, where will you be going?
I'll be going to the ballroom.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
While all is hush in the chalets, a knife-throwing act keeps the adults on the edge of their seats in the ballroom. There's a cabaret several nights a week. The bar does big business in exotic cocktails. And a live band keeps the dancers on the floor until the last waltz.
Last waltz, she lands.